Welcome to the faculty recital. At this time, we ask that you silence electronics, such as cell phones, and refrain from flash photography, so you don't distract the performers or each other. Enjoy.
Welcome to the concert tonight. My piece is an unfamiliar piece for solo violin, so I thought I would tell you a little bit about it because I always feel it's kind of nice to have something to listen for when you listen to a piece that's unfamiliar. So I met Hilary Tann a bunch of years ago and performed some of her music and then invited her to a former university I used to teach at and then played this piece for her. But let me read her program note for this. It's called the Cresset Stone. A Cresset Stone is a medieval method of lighting, a hollowed-out stone filled with oil with a lighted wick. Near the composer's home in Ferndale, Wales, the ancient cathedral at Brecon contains a remarkable example of such a stone. It was this stone, in its stone cathedral context, which directly inspired the composition. The Cresset Stone is a meditation on stone and light, which begins and ends in stillness. The intersection contains reference to the final Kyrie of an 11th century Gregorian chant. The cathedral at Breton was built in the Norman era around 1090, so it's been around a while. And the piece, as she said, has a Kyrie in it from around that time, and I thought I'd just play the main tune of that. Lasts about 3 hours, this piece. That's the Kyrie. And the picture of this Cresset Stone is it's a stone tablet about like that big, with 30 little 3-inch wells. It's kind of like a votive, like in the Catholic Church, where they have a wick in there and some oil. And so the opening gesture of the piece, I think, is a candle flame being disturbed by a little jet of air.
Thank you. Thank you. Berio's, the avant-garde composer Luciano Berio's 96th birthday. He wrote 14 sequenzas from 1958 to 2002. They're avant-garde music, so give it a chance, please. And this is just an excerpt. The work is about 18 minutes long. If this is intriguing to you, he wrote several of the other sequenzas are of interest to me personally. The first one for flute from 1958 is very interesting. The fifth one was written for trombone, but the trombonist wears a clown outfit. The 12th one is for bassoon, and the 13th is for the accordion. So, anyway, this is Luciano Berio. This is an excerpt from the Sequenza 11 composed in 1988.
Thank you.
The second piece, the short piece, is once the title's explained, it's somewhat ironic in that in 2020 we were all so distant, we couldn't even be together, couldn't sit next to anybody. It was really kind of a sad situation, as we all recall. And so this homage to 2020, the tune, the title Slow Drag, comes from in Philadelphia, they used to, when people dance close, they would call it a slow drag. So this is a kind of a meditative little dance.
Thank you. Thank you. The Air and Scherzo by Henry Cowell was written for the great saxophonist, classical saxophonist, Sigurd Roscher. And my predecessor here at Whitworth and former teacher Sylvia Baker was a student of his and had a direct hand and influence in getting this piece off the ground and putting it together some, 60 years now ago. So we hope you will enjoy Air and Scherzo.
Thank you.